Now, this circuit board right here is a hidden gem. And I not only say that because it was previously featured in my AliExpress hidden gem video series, but also because it really is super useful. I mean, you simply hook up a lithium battery to its inputs and you get stable 3.3 volts or 5 volts out of it to power your projects, which initially sounds like nothing special. But then you realize that the circuit only requires 25 microamps of current to keep the output voltage stable, which is awesome news for your super low power projects that need to run for years. I mean, no other voltage converter I got laying around got this feature. And the comment section also seemed to love this board. There is just one tiny problem with it, and that is its size, which in comparison to microcontroller boards is quite huge. But why is this circuit board so big to begin with? I mean, some parts of it are not even populated. Well, to solve this problem, I will try to make my own PCB versions of this board in this video that will get smaller and smaller and ultimately quite tiny, to find out what performance is still possible in that size range. Let's get started! This video is sponsored by Würth Elektronik, my trusty electronics partner that actually inspired this project, because they offer the super tiny inductors here and I was simply curious what they are capable of. But besides inductors, they also offer tons of other electronic components, as well as power and control systems and different PCB technologies. So definitely check them out for high quality products, services and support. And pro tip, they also sell their products on Mauser. Now first off, when it comes to creating such a PCB, then it is all about the IC in the middle and how it wants to get treated. And of course, we can find out all about that in the datasheet of the TPS6302, which, by the way, is 34 pages long. But the typical application circuit actually summarizes most of it. And it says, slap on a good quality inductor, plenty of input capacitors and output capacitors, select the output voltage through the feedback pin with two resistors as a voltage divider, and choose whether you want to enable the IC and or enter the power save mode. So if we cut the not mandatory components and count the rest, then we end up with a minimum of 8 complementary components here. The AliExpress PCB though utilizes 16, so double of that. Now granted, 5 of them are used to select the output voltage, which I can reduce to only 3, because all I want is 3.3 volts and 5 volts on the output. But then they have 3 capacitors on the input and 5 on the output side, which I think is a bit of an overkill, as well as the size of some of them. No, I would rather want to stick to such 0805 capacitors and resistors, not only because I have plenty of them laying around, but also because they represent the perfect balance between being small and still being solderable by hand. So my capacitor and resistor selection was clear to me, and all that was left was choosing a fitting inductor. And like mentioned before, Würth Elektronik sent me over their newest metal alloy power inductors for this job, whose smallest size in this design kit is truly tiny and cute. But according to the datasheet, it is recommended to use a 1.5 microhenry one with a saturation current of 5.1 amps and a DC resistance of 15 milliohm. And luckily for me, here we got one with 1.5 microhenry, 7.8 amps and 60 milliohm, so really close. And what was interesting to me was that this inductor is quite a bit smaller than the generic one used on the AliExpress boards. In fact, almost all power handling components I will use are quite a bit smaller, which got me really excited to find out whether it will perform better or worse than the AliExpress boards. But let's not get ahead of ourselves, because firstly, I had to draw up a schematic for my boards, of which I already explained most, except the power save mode pin and the enable pin, of which I pulled one high to always activate the IC and one low to always be in the low power mode, where the converter only needs 25 microamps. By the way, the AliExpress board has these pins broken out, which also eats up space on the board. And with that being said, my schematic was complete, and it was time to actually design the PCB. And here I simply once again followed the datasheet and its layout suggestion. Summarized, you want big fat copper traces going to the coil and all the power rails. And also keep the coil and capacitors as close as possible to the IC. And then you also got all these circles here, which are called vias. And with them you connect your top copper layer with your bottom copper layer. On the AliExpress PCB you got dozens of them. And the reason why they do this is because the bottom layer is just one big round copper layer, which, as you can imagine, reduces trace resistance and makes designing a lot easier. So according to those recommendations, I created my own board design, which took me around 2 hours. And as a final touch, I threw in some holes as well, because I love to secure my boards with screws. And after ordering them and waiting for a week, they finally arrived. And I think it is easy to see that they're about half the size of the AliExpress boards. So after spreading solder paste with the given stencil, positioning all the components on the boards, and then letting it all reflow solder, my PCB was done and looking pretty good. Time for first tests, and I started with the 5V setting, which to my delight was spot on and, like I hoped for, only drew around 25 microamps on the inputs. The 3.3V output voltage did luckily also work just fine. But of course, to get a better picture about the performance of the boards, I had to draw a varying constant load on the outputs while monitoring the input power as well as the output noise. Now with 3.3V out, the max current was about 2.8 amps. And with 5V out, it was around 2 amps, which I was super happy with. And once I did all the efficiency measurements, I was also happy to find out that it varies between excellent 91% with small loads and acceptable 71% with big loads. And last but not least, we got the noise measurements, which with 3.3 volts and 5 volts were all perfectly fine and didn't even come close to 5% of the output voltage. But keep in mind that this was all done with an input voltage of 3.7 volts, which represents the nominal voltage of a LiPo battery. These values can get better or worse depending on how this voltage changes. And the big question now is how the AliExpress board performs in comparison. And let me make it quick here and say that the max output current was about the same. The efficiency was a bit worse with small loads and better with bigger loads, and the noise level was also a tiny bit less, aka better than my boards. But I think my version is still pretty good considering how we sized down the components. And I wasn't done yet, because there was still room to go smaller. So I went ahead and designed a second version, in which I cut one input capacitor, squeezed everything even tighter together, and placed some capacitors on the backside. In real life that meant I reduced the size once again by around 30%, with the only main difference that this time I had to hand solder capacitors to the back. But as you can see, everything luckily still worked perfectly fine. And after doing my measurements once again, it was clear that the max current was still around the same, the efficiency decreased a bit, and the noise increased a bit, but was still perfectly acceptable. That means this board can also be used without a problem, meaning we can go even smaller, by this time utilizing another even tinier 1 µH inductor from the design kits, that is as big as the main IC itself. So I cut even more capacitors out of the equation and squeezed it all as tightly together as possible, in order to ultimately receive this tiny PCB in the mail. Needless to say, this is quite a bit smaller than the original one, and after once again soldering on all components, it still all worked perfectly fine. At this point, I actually kind of expected a significant drop in performance, but that was not really the case. I mean, yes, the max output current at 3.3 volts decreased to only 2 amps, and the noise did also reach a threshold value that I would not want to exceed. But then again, the efficiency is still looking pretty good, and the board once again does its job just fine. So all in all, I'm very pleased with the outcome here, at least at first sight. Because when designing such PCBs and selling them like they do on AliExpress, then it is crucial to not exceed EMC, aka electromagnetic compatibility limits. But that is a topic for an upcoming video. So subscribe if you want to find out whether my design changes or the AliExpress board exceed such EMC limits. Until then, I hope you enjoyed this video and maybe learned something new. If so, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!